Welcome back to Glastonbury Calling 2019. I'm still in shock that it is Glastonbury Calling 2019 because I remember clear as day last year. Anyway, moving on, can you tell I've had a little bit of lager?
Yeah, exactly.
Now, I have literally stolen Liam. Liam walked in, didn't get a chance to speak to anyone, and I just pulled him out of the crowd. It's like, what for?
But I need to talk to you about Shoto Daito and your up-and-coming set here at Glastonbury Calling. At the assembly room.
Yeah, that's right.
What time are you on?
8.45 till 9.30.
Yes. Now, if you tuned in to BBC Somerset yesterday, you will have heard Ian talking about Shoto Daito.
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Yes, he was bigger than you were.
God bless him.
Yes, because they were talking about... Hold on a minute.
I hope I can...
Was it BBC Somerset?
I'm getting confused because we did a special. It was BBC Somerset.
Yeah.
I can't remember because we did a special on Thursday at GFM as well.
Right, I see. I watched a film, Ready Player One, which has Shoto and Daito. So I don't know if that's the Japanese pronunciation, but we call it Shoto Daito because it sounds better. But it's I think Martin came up with the name, so he's calling it Shoto Daito. I'll call it Shoto.
Okay then. Now, you're getting a bit of a reputation here.
Oh, God.
Those dance moves. No, actually, they're not dance moves, they're just like
on-stage jigs
that you've got going on.
Yeah, I like dancing.
Do you even know you're doing that?
Not really, no.
No.
I'll just feel the music and then just go with it, really.
You do look like you're in another world.
Yeah, I am. I totally. Because otherwise, if I feel I'm in this world, then I'm going to be worried about what's going on around me and I haven't got stuff to concentrate on.
You're a thinker, aren't you?
You're a bit of a thinker, yeah. Forward thinker.
Yeah, you're a very nice.
Yeah, I am.
I think you're okay.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I've seen the way you talk about your cats.
Yeah, love the cats, yeah.
See, there you go. What's coming up for the band then? I know you've been releasing, Body of Water.
Yeah,
that's a really good song.
Yeah. We're working with Dave Breer, who produced that. We're going to work on an album. We've got our last track tonight's called Hysteria, and that's the first song we're going to release out of the next bunch of songs.
Which you can come and hear.
Yes, the last song.
At the assembly rooms.
Yeah, it's quite an epic tune. And then we'll get an album done, get some merch as well.
I thought we were going to be attacked by a cat.
Millie! I thought, yeah, maybe we'll get some t-shirts. Probably because you mentioned that, actually. I think that's got us talking about it, which is great.
Honestly, Paige was going through our clothes, and because she watched this thing on Netflix about how to keep your house tidy or whatever. And so she went through all of my wardrobes, and it was all, I think, 95% merch, just t-shirts and pins up for gigs. So I just wear them, it's so easy to wear.
Yeah.
So, if there was a Shoto Daito t-shirt,
yeah.
I could parade it around.
Oh, I'd love it. I mean, I would be as well. I'd wear them as well. Different colours, I'd wear different colours, and wear one each day.
Oh,
one
with like rainbow colours.
Yeah, well,
like
dipped on. Oh, that'd be amazing.
I think that
I'm sure it really suits Shoto Daito. That'd be quite cool. Well, Amy's the artist, so she'll come up with some really cool art to go with it. So we're quite lucky there that she'll come up with some design that will really suit the band. So there will be something. There will probably mugs and some badges and stuff.
You heard it here first. So if this doesn't happen, I have got evidence.
Yeah, that's that right. Yeah.
Said this.
That's a big responsibility I've got to hold down.
Yes, exactly.
Now, yeah. So not only can they see you at the assembly rooms, but for people who aren't here, they can get your music from Bandcamp,
yes. You can go to Facebook and find some stuff on there. There's the Live at the Grow Roots in Glastonbury. Can't remember when that was, about a year ago, last June, I think. Yeah, last June.
Yeah.
There's a whole set there. That was our first gig between the three of us.
You can also listen to my GFM show, because Liam does the opening jingle.
I do, yeah.
There we go. So you can hear him every Sunday at 107.1. Glastonbury FM, and you can hear Liam sing that.
Brilliant. I'm glad you
like it. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. You enjoy yourself. Have a good fun today.
I will. We've already marched up to the right.
Have you?
And I mean, we marched and realised that we weren't going to march very much today.
I've been at all leisure seeing Rob. He was in happy spirits, so I'm probably going to have to pop there and see him at some point.
Oh, you have to go and see Stevie
and
the Masquerade?
Stevie and the Masquerade, yeah. I think we're planning to have a gig with Shoto actually with them in September.
Oh,
I don't know if that's top secret, but I think we're trying to organise something for Western Supermare. So those two are from Western Supermare, I'm from Glastonbury. Yeah. We're doing a lot of Glastonbury gigs at the moment.
Yeah.
Hopefully get them to do, or us three to do a gig at maybe Brett Bar or something in September. We'll like share the stage with Stevie and the Masquerade.
Excellent.
So watch this space.
Yes, this space.
Cool.